So, toxins, exotoxins versus endotoxin. Exotoxins are polypeptides, endotoxins are lipopolysaccharides. Exotoxins are relatively unstable, endotoxins are stable. Exotoxins are secreted by the cell, actively secreted. Endotoxins are produced by the cell wall of the cell. Then, exotoxin can diffuse in the medium of that culture, endotoxin cannot. Exotoxins are readily separable from the culture, endotoxins are not. Exotoxins have enzymatic action, endotoxin don't have enzymatic action. Exotoxins have specific pharmacological effect on each. That is, each exotoxin is it's specific for or each exotoxin has different specific action. And endotoxin, there is no specificity. Then about the dose, exotoxin can be active in minimum dosage also, but exotoxin can be active in minimum dosage, and endotoxin require large doses. Antigenicity, exotoxin are highly antigenic, endotoxin are less antigenic. Antibody neutralization, exotoxins can be neutralized. Endo cannot. Toxicity. Exotoxins are highly toxic and endotoxins are moderately toxic. Then another thing is toxoid. We can prepare a toxoid of exotoxin by treatment with formaldehyde, but we cannot produce toxoid of endotoxin. Another thing I forgot here is pyrogenicity. The exotoxins are highly pyrogenic, and endotoxins are less pyrogenic. As we have seen about toxicity and antigenicity, same about the pyrogenicity also. Then examples. Usually the exotoxins are produced by gram-positive bacteria, but there are exceptions of gram-negative bacteria, such as Shigella dysentery, Vibrio cholera, and ETEC. So Shigella, Vibrio and ETEC, these are the three gram-negative bacteria which also produce exotoxin. And endotoxins are generally produced by gram-negative, but there are exceptions, such as Listeria is the only gram-positive bacteria which produce endotoxin. And here, Shigella, Vibrio and ETEC.